In today's video, I will show how to make the perfect croquette. And if you are the type of person that never thought about doing a croquette from home, don't worry. The process is super simple and easy to do from home. And as a bonus, I will show an easy marinara sauce that's perfect to go with them. Let's cook. To start, I have two pieces of meat here, a pork shoulder and a short rib. The mix between both will give a fantastic flavor to our croquette. And because we are slow cooking both of them, they will be super tender and delicious. I will clean the short rib from excess fat and silver skin. If I leave it, it will create a weird texture on the final dish with hard to chew bits. When that is done, I will cut both meats into smaller pieces for increased flavor when cooking and season generously with salt and let it sit for 30 minutes. While I wait, let's prepare the vegetables. I'll get the onions and the carrots and roughly chop them into medium-sized pieces. I'll smash our garlics and I'll slice the chorizo into smaller pieces and wait for the meat to season. When there's a layer of water around our meat, it is ready to go. In a large pot, I'll put a little olive oil and when hot, place the meat in and sear it. Add the vegetables in and let the vegetables gain some color. Add a small pinch of salt. Add the chorizo in and let it cook for a minute. And add the garlic. Life is good when you're cooking. Add both the white wine and red wine to get any bits from the bottom of the pan. And add garlic paste, garlic powder, onion powder, tomato paste, brown sugar, fish sauce, dark soy sauce, and the bay leaves. I'll let everything cook for a couple of minutes and add both the chicken and vegetable stocks, and as usual, they are store-bought and just perfect for this type of dish. And I'll add the water to top it up. Mix everything well and bring it to the boil, letting it simmer for 6 hours on low heat. I know, 6 hours, just about enough time to watch the Back to the Future trilogy back to back and still have 20 minutes to spare. 6 hours have passed and you will not believe it, Doc Brown ended up sorry. Our meat is looking perfect and smells amazing. Nice and soft. I will let it cool down a little before removing the meat. I'll put all my meat through the processor and I will pulse it just a couple of times. I want to keep some texture in. I will use the plastic blade to do it as it will not cut the meat and only shred it. Looking great. I'll drain the stock and set it aside. And now, time to prepare our bechamel. In a pan, I'll melt the butter. And when bubbling, I'll add the flour and stir until all the flour is cooked. Then slowly add the meat stock and keep stirring until it becomes a nice thick sauce. Just keep adding stock until it reaches the consistency you want. Something like this is about perfect for what we want. I'll taste to adjust seasoning. It does need some salt. And this is the last seasoning point in the whole recipe. Be sure to adjust salt levels here. I'll add all of the meat into the pan and stir to incorporate everything together. Perfect! Taste to see how it all tastes together. Mmm! Wow! The flavor on the meat is insane. Now let it cool down before placing it in the fridge to solidify. It will make assembling much easier. I left it overnight and you can see the difference in texture now. And now you can build it easily. Get a piece of it to mold it into a cylinder. Try and use something to measure how much you're using. I'm using an ice cream scoop here. The size is of your preference. Do you like them bigger or smaller? So into a cylinder shape, rolling it on the board, tucking the ends and repeat until all the filling is used. By the end of it, if it's starting to get too sticky, just put the pot back in the fridge to solidify again and continue the process from then. When all of them are ready, let's prepare a breading station. And on one plate, beat some eggs, and on the other, some panko. Left hand wet, right hand dry. Pass through the eggs and cover it with panko until it's nice and covered all around. And all of them are ready. See how many you want to fry? And the leftover, we're going to freeze it, so it can be used whenever you want. That's the beauty of this. I know it's a lot of work, but it will give you loads to keep in the freezer and you can enjoy them multiple times without all this work. When they are frozen, move them to bags and store them. They will last up to 3 months in the freezer. With that out of the way, let's cook our croquettes. In a pot filled with vegetable oil, heat up to 200 degrees Celsius or 400 Fahrenheit and fry the croquettes without overfilling the pot. When they are nice and golden, remove and drain excess oil, either in a rack or a paper, and let it cool down for 10 minutes before diving in. And while we wait, let's prepare a dipping sauce that's just perfect for this. In a small pot, I'll drizzle some olive oil. I'll add a can of chopped tomatoes and tomato paste with a pinch of salt. Add the sugar and let everything cook for a minute. And add garlic powder, onion powder, dried oregano, dried basil, chili flakes. I'll add a little bit of water and let everything cook and reduce for 10 minutes. I'll taste for seasoning after the 10 minutes, and perfect, spicy, sweet, sour. It is amazing. And to finish, I'll add some lemon juice to bring it some life. And with all of this ready, only one thing left to do. Time to taste. Let's try it on its own. What a gorgeous crunch. Juicy inside, crunchy outside. Wow. The flavor of it is incredible. Not mushy. You can still feel all the meat in it. Spectacular. And you can really taste the meat. That's the hero of this, for sure. Now let's do a dipping. Wow, 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 wow. I am so happy right now. Brings it tanginess, sweetness, spicy. Wow. Elevates it in a beautiful way. Wow, wow. And this is everything you want in a croquette. Absolutely perfect. Try it. See for yourself. But you might be thinking, I don't really fancy a croquette today. Wait, what about this snack right here? It's also delicious. It might be your type. I will see you there. Bye.